The part of a groundnut that contain seed. Divide them into two portions. Means that part, you have to divide this part into two portions. Shell the groundnuts in one portion. How long did this take you? Now, put the other portion in a cloth bag and tie its mouth. Pound the bag lightly with the stone or beat it with the stick. So student, pound means to hit that bag with the help of, to hit that bag lightly means slowly with a stone or beat it with the stick. Now take the groundnuts out in a tray and tell me what do you see. Means after that, means you have to take some groundnuts, then divide that groundnuts into two portion, into two bags. Then after that, you have to strike that groundnuts with the help of stones or sticks, etc. And then take these groundnuts into a tray. So what do you see? And here, one conversation between Arjun, Madan and Varsha is given in your textbook. So, we will see that conversation. Many of the pods have burst open and the nuts have come out. Burst open means hole or a crack caused by the hitting stones or by beating with stick. Means burst means some cracks are made by the process of that hitting or striking the beating with the stick. That's why what happened, the nuts have come out. Mother says this can be called threshing. This can be called threshing of pods. Means threshing means to separate the grains. Threshing means to separate the grains. So student, now hold the tray in both the hand, both your hands. Toss it contents quickly and lightly in the air. So toss means to throw something lightly or move up and down in air. Toss means to throw something lightly in air or move up and down. So, mother says, Varsha says, when I toss the tray, the empty shells falls off and the nuts are left behind. But why does that happen? Then mother says, the shells are light, so they get blown by air and fall off. The nuts are heavier and are left behind. While winnowing too, the drop of air is used to separate the grain from the chaff. Now, winnowing means in Marathi it is called as pakhadne. To blow through grain in order to remove its outer covering. Means winnowing. Winnowing means to remove the outer covering. It blow through, the grains are blowing in a air. Okay, and the drop of air is used to separate the grain from the chap. Now chap means what? It is a worthless thing, or it is also called as rubbish. In simplest word, it is called as rubbish. Now let's go on with the story. Dada uses a machine for threshing and winnowing. In the machine, threshing and winnowing are done at the same time. The harvested ears are put into the machine and the grains get separated and falls into the bag tied to the machine. Means by using machine, the both the things, means harvesting and threshing and winnowing, both the things is done at a time. Okay student, so this is the use of machine. The chaff and the other rubbish get blown off. When there were no machine, bullocks were made to help with the threshing. For winnowing, a person stand a little higher up and slowly allows the threshed. Means when there are when the machines are not available at that time, bullocks are used. Bullocks were made to help the threshing, and for winnowing this process, a person stand little higher up and slowly allow the threshed the grains to fall to the ground. The chaff is carried away by the draught and the grains falls down in a heap. The machine helps to finish the work quickly, but labor and expense have to be put in any case. Means by using machine, this all the work is done very quickly, and labors and expense have to be put in. So student, here one picture is given for threshing process. Means machines were not available at that time, bullocks were used for this threshing process. If machine is not available, bullocks do the threshing. A round space is cleared in the field and the threshing floor is prepared. A post is erected at its center and a bullock is tied to it. The bullock walks in a circle around the post, and the harvested ears are spread in the round space so that they get trampled upon by the bullock. If the crop is large in quantity, the bigger place, means here, the bigger place is prepared and more bullocks are used together. Means here only one bullock. You will see here, you are seeing here only one bullock. When the large quantity, we have to, if the crop is in large quantity, then you have to need the bigger place, and also two bullocks are used, means more bullocks are used together. Threshing may go on for several days. Means it is not possible to complete the threshing work in one day or in some hours. No, this work goes on for several days. For the bullocks too, this is heavy work, and this work is also very heavy. So student, you see the picture, you able to see this picture na? Means before some days, before means machines are not available at that time, such a kind of work is done for threshing process. So the grains obtained after winnowing is filled in a sack. Proper care is taken to make sure that it will not be attacked by insect or other pest such as mice and rats. After putting aside some grains for the family, the remaining sacks are sent to the market, place to be sold. When the trader there buy the grain, trader means a person who buy and sell the things in the market. It's called as trader. It's known as trader. The person who buy and sells the things in the market is called as trader. There buy the grains. The farmer gets money for the crop that he has grown. So students, nowadays you always see for harvesting, for threshing, winnowing, all process are done by using machine. No bullocks are used in nowadays. So students, you understood the lesson up to here. Next part we will continue in next lesson. Stay home, stay safe. Thank you.